Tina's joining us here in the studio. Chairman, good morning to you.
Good morning,
I know you're going to be really very busy, so let's do a run through, sir. Undas, how is preparations? Actually, what I wanted to find out, sir, was the buses.
Yes.
You lifted the number coding, but what I read was from October 30 to 31. Was it only?
Yes, for the provincial buses, kasi automatic na yung November 1 and 2.
Ah, okay.
Because of the clamor of the Provincial Bus Operators Association, because of the ongoing road repairs in Santa Fe, Nueva Vizcaya, as
Aurora.
Well as Aurora and Pitogo, Quezon, as well as to meet the COMELEC registration deadline.
So lifted 30-31 and obviously holiday 1
yes.
and 2. Okay. For regular vehicles, sir? Ganun din?
Hindi po. November 1 and 2 na yan.
Oh, but you know what I found out? Kasama na Makati this
yes,
time.
Yes.
And Las Piñas.
Yes, yes.
All right. There was also a report, sir, that you've been making the rounds also of cemeteries. Can you
yes.
tell us more about that?
Mas elaborate itong Undas 2012. We're covering almost 29 cemeteries, focusing on the four major cemeteries for on-site and off-site services. For instance, we cleaned up South Cemetery and North Cemetery prior to Undas sa Maynila.
Mm-hmm.
And then after Undas, we'll clean up both cemeteries again, November
really?
4, November
okay.
3. So we're providing public assistance services. We deployed emergency teams, wheelchairs for the elderly, as well as the disabled, traffic assistance, among others.
But you mentioned Manila North and South Cemetery.
Yes.
What were the other two? You said there were four.
Manila Memorial and Loyola Marikina.
I see. But Manila Memorial, that's the one in Sucat?
Yes.
Okay, and then Loyola Memorial
yes.
in... Loyola Memorial din kasi sa Sucat. Eh.
Yes, yes. I'm referring to Manila Memorial,
okay.
which is the bigger one.
All right, so those are in place already.
Yes.
Have you heard any problems so far, sir?
Yung problem namin is the some areas in Quezon City, particularly Bagbag, Novaliches, and Sangandaan, because of some diggings being done by a water concessioner, perhaps. So, merong rerouting scheme. In fact, I have here 9 rerouting schemes for 9 LGUs.
Ah, really, sir?
And na-post na ho ito sa website namin ngayon.
Okay, so maybe it's better for them to check your website.
www.mmda.com.ph. Specifically
okay.
those
traversing.
Yes, traversing the Quezon City, Novaliches area, as well as those going to the North Cemetery.
Okay.
The Manila Police District prepared a traffic advisory. Nakalabas na rin po ito. And starting midnight today, we're going to have a rerouting near the South Cemetery adjacent to the Makati area of JP Rizal.
Ah, really?
Yeah, so mayroong mga pagbabago doon. So, all of these 9 nilabas na namin sa website namin, but I can mention a few.
Can we, sir, please?
For instance, North Cemetery, some streets would be designated as parking areas, Craig Street, Felix Huerta Street. So, these are no parking zones, meaning to say that you will be towed pag nagpumarada kayo doon. Ganun din dito sa Pasig, some areas near si Raymundo, no parking along si Raymundo, Mercedes Avenue to Angeles Street. And then the same is true with some areas in Malabon, but this won't affect generally the central areas of Manila. So ito po lahat nakalagay sa website namin. And what we did today as an upgrade is to involve even the NLEX and SLEX.
Okay.
So I asked NLEX to go beyond their turf at pumunta sila dun sa Balintawak Market. Tulungan kami na paluwagin yung Balintawak Market para yung pabalik na hindi gagamit na Mindanao Avenue, maalis yung mga naka-illegally parked dun.
And they were very cooperative about
yes.
that.
Mm-hmm. And then,
how about the South, sir?
Yesterday, I supervised the construction of a temporary parking area for those visiting heritage and libingan ng mga bayani. It's along C5.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Ito po yung nagiging source ng traffic doon going out of SLEX. So, meron tayo yung Middle Island near that CP Garcia Monument, which can accommodate at least 300 vehicles in coordination with the Taguig Traffic Bureau, of course.
You know, sometimes, you know, it becomes a little bit of a surprise when you talk about the MMDA, of course, traffic, basura, problema, no? And then I see how focused you are looking, of course, at cemeteries and what you do in coordination, of course, with various local
LGUs,
government
yes.
units and members of the police force, sir. Bus terminals, let's talk about that. How's that? Any problems there so far?
So far, no negative news yet. Cubao is okay. Yesterday, I visited Filtranco. Okay pa naman sa Pasay. Ang maganda nito, ang haba ng weekend. They started moving, and then semestral break, so they started moving out of the city mas maaga.
Yeah. That's why I was thinking, Chairman, maybe today, ako wala akong na-experience sa traffic, but I come a little early, no? So, ano talaga ako, hindi ko masyado talaga naabutan ng traffic. But I think, is it fair to say or safe to say that maybe from here on till November 1, 2, mukhang doesn't look like?
Except for a DPWH reblocking project which would commence on the 2nd of November.
Where?
EDSA southbound near the Philam subdivision before Quezon Avenue.
Okay.
So it's from November 2 to 5. I just approved that. So, the fifth lane.
So parang sa harapit ng almost ng Trinoma. I mean sa opposite ng Trinoma,
yes,
di ba? Doon
yes.
Banda 'yon. So southbound 'yon November 2.
To
so
November
that
5.
Will be eksakto lang, sir.
Yes.
Kasi Friday naman siguro.
But we expect the influx November 4, between
Saturday 3. Saturday and Sunday, sir.
Yes, 3 to 7, 3 to 8.
Mm-mm. But yeah, at least that's also a good time to work.
Yes.
Diba? I mean, members of the police force have canceled their leaves. I'm sure the MMDA, I understand you're deploying about 2,000 MMDA
2,387
personnel.
2,387 to be exact.
2,000. Ilan ba kayo dun sa 2,387?
Yung 2,387 kasama na yung street sweepers, emergency crew, nurses, paramedics, traffic enforcers, lahat po yan.
Saan ang concentration, Chairman? I mean, is it equally distributed? I'm sure you...
The four.
Yeah.
The four. North, South, Manila Memorial, Sukat, and Loyola.
What is the difference between your program this year compared to last year?
Mas well planned, I think. Modesty aside, mas... in sync with other agencies, but we hope to, evolve next year into just one central command center for all of this, similar to what we've been doing during disaster operations.
Okay.
So we hope to have next year in place a central command base.
Well, ngayon naman nandun yun sa MMDA, hindi ba?
Nandun po yan, but in terms of. Synchronizing all the efforts, like for instance, I just mentioned na ito yung mga rerouting. So even if you have a rerouting in Pasig,
mm-mm.
it's supposed to be not a standalone program. It would affect Taguig,
right,
yes, and City, Makati.
So connection, yeah.
Yes, we
so
have to have.
Yes.
Yes.
Aguila 2 has been launched, sir. I didn't know Aguila 1. For those who might have missed that report. I did that report yung sa Aguila 1. Holy Week pala yun.
Yes,
so ito
yung
mobile van ng
yes,
MMDA.
Yes.
Meron siya mga screens sa loob.
Yes.
It actually, you deploy it to get to places not blind
yes,
spots for
yes,
you guys.
Yes.
So you have one. Now you have Aguila 2.
Yes.
Okay.
Aguila 2 has just been dispatched to the North Cemetery.
Ah, dun siya.
Aguila 1 is right now, I visited Aguila 1 6 a.m. nasa South Cemetery.
Ah, okay.
Nasa loob siya. And Aguila 3 will be deployed sa Manila Memorial, Sukat.
Ah, may 3 na ba?
Yes.
Sir? Okay. Okay, so tatlo na yon. Siguro, Chairman, kayo na magsabi, for those who might not have seen it, how does that help the MMDA?
CCTV, we cover a bigger area not seen by our CCTVs
command
base. And then, binabato niya sa command base. So, interlink lahat yan. And then, we provide some feeds to the police as well.
Mm-mm. So, let's say, the one in the Manila North Cemetery, nakatutok lang po yun doon.
North lang sa loob.
Tapos, nakatingin various points sa loob ng Manila North Cemetery.
Yes,
ganun
yes,
po yun,
yes.
Di ba? And the south is the same.
Sa south lang.
Okay, and sa Loyola would be the same.
Yeah.
And then, if there are any problems, ibabato po nila sa command base
yes,
agad.
Yes.
And makakalakad po ang personnel ng
yes,
MMDA.
Yes, but nakakoordinate din sa police sa assigned sa cemetery.
Right, right. What is your plan about these Aguilas, sir? How many actually do you intend to have?
Siguro three more and
pero malaking tulong, sir.
Yes, kasi kulang tayo ng CCTV. So pag nagkaroon na dagdagan na tayo, I think mas makakadagdag ng visibility. More eyes the better.
Of course, sir. Chairman, anything else we need to know about Undas that the public needs to know?
I'd like to focus on the garbage.
Okay.
Last year we hold I think 200 trucks of debris coming out of North Cemetery. So I advise the general.
Only North?
Yes, advise the general public that siguro makiisa na, ilabas na natin yung basura natin. We'll take care of the flowers. and they melted candles, pero yung garbage, take care of the garbage.
I wish we would really find that in ourselves, sir, to discipline yung sa yung basurang tinatapo natin. Tayo din sanang responsable for that.
Yes, the recent Sandy superstorm in the East Coast, makita natin madali nag-subside yung water because walang basura.
Mm-mm. Tayo, nahihirapan mag-subside dahil puro tayo yes. basura. Again, of course, that's a call for each and every one of us na mag-ingat ho tayo or let's be a little bit more disciplined dun sa tinatapo natin basura because understandably, that is part of your job, but we as citizens also have to take responsibility for that. All right, so that is Undas. From here, where are you going, sir? Nasaan ka ba?
I'll be going to Loyola.
Okay.
But I have to transfer to your radio station.
Sa DCMM.
And then this afternoon, okay. I think we're going to accompany the president on inspection.
Ah, paikot, sir. Okay. You had just arrived from Korea.
Yes.
And our reporter was with you, Maan Makapagala. No? She was telling me about it. And I was asking her, what is it like? What were you doing there? And what is the plan for Metro Manila?
It was a quick 19-hour trip.
Wala nga daw halos pahinga.
Yes. I brought along with me Secretary Singson of DPWH and newly appointed Secretary Junabayo of the OTC. The purpose of which is to really have one common perspective on how to approach the central bus terminal. So we all agreed that there is a need there. There is an urgent need to have a centralized bus terminal for Metro Manila. So we're going to have three. So one would be to cater to northern commuters, provinces, and two would be for the south, southeast, southwest, going to Visayas, Bicol, and another one for Cavite and Batangas.
Mm-hmm.
So the three of us would be joining hands. Mm-hmm. The three of us would be initiating the bus terminals, not as standalone, but as interconnected terminals. So if you're waiting for your bus to arrive in coastal, for instance, going to Cavite, makikita mo rin anong time darating yung bus coming from La Union.
That's nice, sir.
Or Bicol. So mm-hmm. it would be akin to an international airport.
You know, Chairman, I don't know if you're the one that talked to me about this or I think it was you. Yung plano mo talaga na maglagay ng terminal somewhere in the north, somewhere in the south, and somewhere to cater to Batangas and Cavite. No? With your talk with the secretaries of the OTC and the DPWH, does it seem like it can actually happen because you have a lot of plans, sir. Even on EDSA, meron kang plano sana doon.
Mm-hmm.
Pero syempre, hindi naman purkit plano mo ma-approve ng iba. Diba? That takes a lot of cooperation, funding, etc. Does it look like that's gonna happen, sir?
Yes. Nagkakaisa na kaming tatlo. Nagkakaisa kaming tatlo. So, to simplify everything, Secretary Abaya would be in charge of the Northern Bus Terminal.
Okay.
Secretary Babe Singson for the Southeastern bus terminal.
Mm-mm.
Ako naman doon sa Southwestern.
Ano ba? Sorry, yes, sir. Ano ba Southeastern?
Southeastern would be FTI.
Ah, okay.
To cater sa mga buses going to Bicol, Laguna, Visayas,
okay.
Mindanao.
Ah, pati Visayas, Mindanao, yeah, doon sa Southeastern, yes, FTI. Yes, and then yes. Southwestern will be?
Cavite and Batangas.
I see.
MMDA naman yun.
What is the plan there, sir? How long is that going to take? And plus, next question, what's going to happen to the terminals along EDSA?
Mawawala na yun.
Thank you, sir.
Luluwag na yun. So,
promise. Okay.
So, ang sabi ko nga doon sa dalawa, mag-competition na lang tayo, una-unahan makatapos.
Pero sir, hindi ho ba meron silang posibleng kontrata na kailangan i-fulfill doon sa pwedeng inuupahan nilang lote sa EDSA or posibleng pagmamayari nila yon? Because frankly, that is a huge problem for traffic, sir.
Yeah. What would happen is that the DOTC through the LTFRB would just amend the franchise. For instance, if your endpoint is Cubao, ang endpoint mo ngayon is FTI. Or coastal.
So either magsa-southwestern ka or yes. southeastern ka or north.
So mawawala talega yon.
You don't foresee any other problems. I mean, I'm sure they will raise protests against that plan of yours. But again, I say that's not new. I've heard it from you before.
Yeah, siguro TRO is not cannot be
stopped.
Yes, pero I think they would realize.
Really?
You know the terminal in Korea, the name of the terminal in Korea, Gangnam Bus Terminal.
Pero bakit sabi ni Maan, ay yung Gangnam daw doon?
It's a district.
Gangnam.
Yes, it's a district. Oh.
Okay, that sounds like a really good idea for EDSA, sir.
And the president already issued an executive order. Okay, for good, this. Executive sir. Order number 67.
When kaya, sir? Kailan kaya ito mag-uumpisa? I mean, what year?
I think mauuna yung North.
What year?
Mauuna.
Next 20. Year? Next ah, talaga? Year? May 2013
North,
na, sir?
North would be kinukonstruct na.
Talaga?
Yung southeast, yung southwest, MMDA, the plan was presented to me yesterday, the other day.
Sir, sorry, saan ang southwest? Southeast is FDI.
Yeah, southwest is coastal.
Yes, saan mismo in around that area?
Near a proposed terminal of the LRT extension one, line one extension.
Okay.
It's gonna be near Naiya Road, near
okay.
Near the proposed Pagcor.
Sabi ng kapat, banda doon.
Yes.
Oh, kasi mukhang there are empty lots there, ha?
Yes.
Okay, malapit doon sa dating duty free.
No, malayo doon.
Pagcor.
No. There's another Pagcor
on Mia, sir, on Naiya Road. Leading to Sukat, is that what you're talking about?
No, leading to MOA area.
I'm sorry, okay, I got it wrong. Okay, banda doon. Mm. All right, that sounds like a really good idea, sir. What about your problem with buses and traffic? Traffic, of course, probably we still see problems on EDSA.
That's for the provincial buses. For the city buses, we implement the bus segregation scheme comes December.
What is a bus
segregation scheme? Ito yung bus stop A, bus stop B. So if you're bus A, stop ka lang sa bus stop A. If you're bus B,
stop ka lang sa bus stop B.
B stands for Baclaran, A stands for Alabang. Kasi yun yung endpoint. So
either Baclaran ka lang o Alabang. Go
yes. So yung implementation would be hindi abot ng Pasko this year.
Wow. Bilis ah, sir. Okay, what about problems with accidents, sir? I know hindi nyo naman ho talaga, inyo lang yan, but the fact remains that marami pa rin, sir, overspeeding. I'm sure you see it. Ako, I see it every day, sir. Pag walang MMDA official dyan, nagta-traffic talaga bago mag-Guadalupe kasi yung mga bus talagang, they take up three lanes. But when they see an MMDA official there, sir, walang halos, you breeze through traffic on EDSA.
So, education really plays an important role here, eh?
And penalties, probably,
yes.
Sir.
That's another reason why, for this coming film fest, we launch a cell phone film festival involving students, and with just only one theme: road courtesy.
Okay.
And we have 60 outstanding entries. Pinapakita yung road courtesy. Yung iba po doon, anak ng bus driver.
Talaga?
Lahat yun makikita sa MMDA website. And you can vote online.
Oh, okay.
So education nga. Education plays an important role.
That's nice, sir. I guess because recently also we've had problems with bus accidents in Nova. Of course, that's still under investigation by the LTFRB under Attorney Jacob. But, you know, you can imagine kayo nadaanan nyo, hindi nyo po nakita mismo yung aksidente, pero nadaanan nyo, it caused a lot of traffic na, you know, the usual excuse, sir, is nawalan sila ng preno. Yeah. The fact remains, they're not scared, sir. Even changes need to be implemented there. And, you know, they should take their jobs more seriously, sir. Kasi parang normal na sa kanila na
But overall, I think we have reduced, especially Commonwealth, especially motorcycle.
Absolutely, sir.
Because of the motorcycle side, because of the speed limit.
Yes, sir.
So we have lessened.
Uh-oh.
So, but we cannot probably totally eradicate, but we have lessened. There may be near fatalities, pero hindi gaya 2010 or 2009.
Understandable. I mean, that much I'll say, sir, Commonwealth has improved tremendously. Even, I see a lot of people actually, sir, and let me congratulate you for that, along Makapagal Avenue. Talagang kahit ako, nagmamaneho ng 60 doon kasi natatakot ako nakasulat, camera enforced.
And we have pictures.
Uh-huh.
We have pictures.
Have you, pero yan yung sa Nova, sir, diba? Yan yung nag-usap tayo niyan, nadaanan mo yan, pero you didn't really see the accident. Pero it's a culture, sir, probably that needs to be changed.
It's
as well.
Siguro company policies of the bus operator would have to be changed in a radical manner before the end of the year. I forgot to mention the bus pay for bus drivers will be implemented.
Finally?
Yes.
Hindi na po
commission. So, you can validate this DOLE. I think that would help.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. You know, it's funny, sir. That has been discussed over and over again for many years, and finally this year, it will actually come true.
Yes.
There's an issue on traffic signal bidding, sir.
Yes.
So MMDA.
Yes, we just got a. There's a losing bidder who filed a case against us, asking the court that they be awarded through the judicial mode. But the court came out with a resolution order the other day, affirming the actions taken by MMDA to be transparent and to be in compliance with Republic Act 9184. So it settles everything.
Mm-hmm.
But the problem is it came out in the media and dami nakabasa that it settles everything. That what we did was transparent, and we even upgraded the bidding committee to include officials of the Department of Transportation, Public Works, not Transportation, Science and Technology. And we even got the Imperial College of London as a traffic signalization consultant for MMDA.
What happened to you? I mean, you were a mayor in Tagaytay, and all of a sudden you are into all this traffic, garbage, segregation. Obviously, sir, you must be in a way because you are the MMDA chairman, but that's a complete, you know, not a complete shift, because as mayor, dinadaan, you know, pero how you are so engrossed in this?
That's gradual. That's different from your Frankenstorm. That's gradual. When you study.
Diba? Okay, let's just remind our viewers that beginning December, or prior to the end of the year, the bus, I just wanted to remind them, sir, the bus segregation will finally happen. So for those riding buses, either bus A ka lang or bus B.
Yes.
Manila to A is Baclaran, B.
Another feature probably for EDSA is that first week of December, we're going to launch the vertical gardens of EDSA. If you've seen the underpasses with railings, garden po yun. These are wall gardens.
Kaya pala nagtataka ako kung ano yun. Yung para may mga wires,
yes,
sir.
Yes.
Oo, kasi actually, sir, I was also wondering, since you're at the topic, on the topic, yung pong underpass sa ilalim ng Araneta, sa EDSA, sir?
Yes.
Bakit kung ganun yun? Meron yung mga parang tiles dun sa ilalim na puti. Ano yun?
Ah, the tiles?
Oo.
Alam mo yung
pagtatiles. Hindi ko maintindihan kung banyo.
Yung pagtatiles, international standard. You go to Tokyo.
Ganun
you go
ba?
To Hong Kong.
Puti, sir?
To be easily cleaned. Madumi talaga yon. Madaling linisin. Other cities are doing this.
But sir,
Guangzhou is doing this.
But the tiles are just like three rows. Hindi naman po siya.
That's a different one. But if you pass by Show Boulevard Tunnel, kompleto na yon.
Ah, ganun ba?
Oh, kompleto. We plan to finish that.
Pero lalagyan niyo pa ng ano yan?
Yes.
Virtual gardens.
Yeah, at the end of the tiles, yung tiling, nandun yung garden.
I see. So sadya pala yon.
Yung garden would be in place before the feast day of the Immaculate Conception.
So, first that's December 8th.
Yeah, December.
All right. And you have e-scooters.
Yes, naka-deploy sila ngayon sa major cemeteries. So, for maneuverability as well as visibility.
Mm-hmm.
And less gasoline expenditure.
Ano yan, sir? I'm sorry, no, I'm not aware of that. Paano bang gamit niyan?
You charge it like a cell phone.
Electric operated.
Yes, it runs 40 kph.
Okay. For how long?
No emission, 8 hours.
Tapos
1 hour of charging.
1 hour lang ang charging.
1 hour of charging.
Tapos 8 hours mo
eight
pwedeng gamitin.
Yes, oo.
Daig pa ang iPhone.
Nasa ano sila ngayon? I think this is a video of North Cemetery.
Mm-mm-mm. How many of those do you have, sir?
Konti pa lang yan. Less than 15. But hopefully we can have, ideal nito is 30 or 40 for Metro Manila.
How much is one?
We got that cheap, less than 35.
35,000 ang isa. And then you're looking at about 50. So it's three wheels.
Yes.
So madali pa lang ano yan. You don't really need to balance with that one.
It's being utilized in other countries as well.
Okay, so again, sir, I know you are going through, you're going to be going, doing the rounds. Can we find out your inspection with the president later? Where are you off to?
I was just informed that we have to be in... I think proper announcements will be made.
You don't want to tell. Sa kanila na lang manggaling, sir, ano? Okay, but definitely, you guys will be making the rounds with the president. Siguro, for security reasons, hindi muna natin sasabihin exactly where. And there's no leaves, ano, for your personnel in MMDA. And sir, kamusta na po yung sa Facebook niyong, ano, tauhan? yung pong merong concerned citizen that took a picture na mamagapot.
We helped him. The problem with the guy is that ayaw niya magpa-check up. Mm-hmm. So we gave him a rehab leave, which would allow him to enter a hospital without decreasing his pension. So right now he's on rehab leave and he will retire on the 15th of December.
Oo. Actually, that's what he was saying. Kaya ayaw na daw niya magpa-check up dahil pa-retire na rin daw siya.
Marami po kaming ganun.
Ng problema.
Marami po kaming ganun.
Lastly, sir, your personnel on clearing operations, are they still having problems being harassed and all that?
Meron pa ho yun.
But not as bad as before, sir. I don't really see, or is it? I don't see it much in the
Hindi lang siguro na-expose, pero meron pa rin on, especially dun sa mga sidewalk. Some of them, may mga kaso ng human rights. Ganon. So, marami pa hong ganon. But we help them. Provide legal assistance.
Yeah. That's the risks of, one of the risks, of course, of being part of the clearing operation of the MMDA. So the chairman will need to go and make the rounds, probably cemeteries, I don't know. He will be with the president a little later on. So Chairman, thank you so much for coming over.
Thank you, and happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween. Good luck, sir. I'm looking forward to all your new programs. Uh-huh. A lot of them will be implemented by December. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Disney buys the Star Wars franchise and Angelica Panganiban goes public about her relationship with John Lloyd Cruz. We'll give you the latest in business and showbiz when Mornings at ANC returns.